Welcome to St. Mark's Lutheran Church, located in Charlotte, North Carolina. St. Mark's is a historic congregation of the ELCA that unconditionally welcomes all people of all ethnicities, genders, identities, and backgrounds. There's a place for you at St. Mark's. We are conveniently located in Myers Park on Queens Road, just south of Charlotte's Uptown and adjacent to the Duke Mansion and the greenery of Edgehill Park. St. Mark's Church building is easy to find with its marble Christus Victor, while inside, the mid-century design of the sanctuary reaches upward, inspiring us with Christ's blessing and beautiful stained glass windows featuring all the people of God in all their diversity. There is a place for you at St. Mark's.
Please be seated. Good morning and welcome to St. Mark's Lutheran Church. As we continue the season of Christmas, today we celebrate the witness of Simeon and Anna, whose eyes had seen God's salvation prepared in the presence of all people. A blessed Christmas to all of you, and on this last day of the year, a blessed New Year to you all. A warm welcome to any visitors who are worshiping with us this morning. Your presence among us is a blessing to us. I have a few announcements today about our parish life. Next Sunday, on January 7th, we will return to two services at 8:30 and 10:30 on Sunday morning. And next Sunday morning, January 7th, we will also celebrate the Epiphany of our Lord. And our sanctuary will remain decorated through Epiphany Sunday services. A word about today's Holy Communion. There will be two stations for Holy Communion today in front of the freestanding table, and communion will be distributed from the front of this table. Room in the Inn is still, I think, seeking to fill a couple of slots, and if you're interested in serving in Room of the Inn, please see the sign-up boards out in the gathering place. And this is the first announcement. It's in the remarks, it's been in the bulletin, but the first verbal announcement that our annual meeting is coming up at the end of next month on January 28th. And the annual written reports will be available on Sunday, January 14th. Finally, if you're joining us online this morning, we're grateful and thankful you're with us. And if you haven't been to St. Mark's before or haven't been to St. Mark's in a while, please consider joining us at 8:30 or 10:30 on Sunday morning for worship. Call us or email us in our church office that we might be able to get to know you. We've come to worship our Lord. Let us quiet our hearts now as we prepare for worship. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the Word made flesh, our life and our salvation. Amen. Trusting in the goodness and loving kindness of God our Savior, let us confess our sin. God of life, you promise good news of great joy for all people, and call us to be messengers of your peace. We confess that too often we hoard our joy, our resources, and our security. We nurture conflict and build barriers. We neglect the needs of our neighbors and ignore the groaning of creation. Have mercy on us. Where we are self-centered, open our hearts. Where we are reluctant, give us courage. Where we are cynical, restore our trust. Renew us with your grace and give us again the hope of eternal life in you. Amen. Hear the good news. We are children of God and heirs of God's promises through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus we are forgiven and redeemed. Sing with joy, for all the ends of the earth shall know the salvation of God. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you wonderfully created the dignity of human nature and yet more wonderfully restored it. In your mercy, let us share the divine life of the one who came to share our humanity, Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
The first reading is from Isaiah chapter 61. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me in the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, As a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest until her vindication shines out like the dawn and her salvation like a burning torch. The nations shall see your vindication and all the kings your glory, and you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sovereigns of the earth and all peoples,
has raised up strength for the people and praise for all faithful servants. The children of Israel, a people who are near to the Lord. Alleluia.
Second reading is from Galatians 4. But when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child, and if a child, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to St. Luke, the second chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the time came for their purification, according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. As it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your own salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel. And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, This child is destined for the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too. There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was of great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, then as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but worshiped there with fasting and prayer night and day. At that moment she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of God was upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Good morning. Today, on the last morning of the year, Paul's words about the fullness of time remind me that this year is ending. Paul writes, "But when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son. What began 12 months ago as an unknown and uncharted year has reached the fullness of time." And so I ask, have you had a good Christmas? Have you again welcomed Christ into your hearts? During the brief Christmas season, we remember that Jesus, born of Mary in Bethlehem, shared our human lives and our human time. Paul's words about the fullness of time remind me of the fullness of Jesus' life, his birth and ministry, his cross and death and resurrection, and his ascension. He is the fullness of God's time that can fill our moments, our days, our years, and our entire lifetimes. He is the fulfillment of time who will fill your life with his Spirit of grace and peace. Of this, Paul writes, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. The Spirit of Jesus Christ, the eternal Word of God, who fulfills time, lives in our hearts. The Christmas season is about a birth into the chronos of human time, the time we measure in moments, in seconds, in hours, in days, months, years, and eventually a lifetime. He is the fulfillment of all time. And he is born to share our human time and all of our moments. Nowhere do we see this as strikingly as in the figures of Simeon and Anna in Luke's gospel, who praised God when they saw the baby Jesus. Both Simeon and Anna were advanced in years and yet spoke as if they had seen the one for whom they had been waiting their entire lives. Simeon said, Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples. Simeon is saying what we all know, Jesus' birth is for every person, nation, for this entire world. We might call the moment Simeon saw Jesus as Simeon's Christmas Day, for Simeon had seen Christ Jesus and was at peace in his life because now Jesus and a hope for the future lived in him. Simeon's words, Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, meant that Simeon could now die in peace with faith, having seen the Messiah. The baby that Simeon saw would grow into adulthood, becoming a rabbi who taught, healed, comforted, and forgave, and who welcomed and gave his life for many. He did this so that we also might heal, comfort, forgive, welcome, and give our lives for many over our lifetime, sharing our humanity with him so that through us he shares his life for others. Have you had a good Christmas? Have you also welcomed Christ into your heart? The English poet and dean of St. Paul's Cathedral in London, John Donne, preached on this theme on Christmas Day a long time ago in 1526, and Donne had the following to say on Christmas Day in 1626. To be able to conclude that you have had a Christmas Day, a manifestation of Christ in your soul, you shall have a whole Good Friday, a crucifying and it is finished in your life. You will have temptations and a resurrection and an ascension. Make good your Christmas Day, that Christ be born in you
and he who died for you will live with you all the year and all the years of your lives, and inspire into you and receive you at your last gasp the blessed acclamation, "Now, Lord, lettest thou thy servant depart in peace." End of quote. The baby that Simeon took into his arms would carry the cross in his own arms and would say the words, "It is finished," fulfilling God's time of salvation for all peoples. And so again I ask, have you had a good Christmas? Have you again welcomed Christ into your heart? Like Simeon, when you receive the bread and take the cup today at communion, at the Eucharistic table, the bread you receive and the cup you drink is the fullness of Christ that you hold in your hand. It is the Christ who was born and died and was raised for you. Hold this bread and take this cup, like Simeon saying, "My eyes have seen your salvation." Long before our cultural Christmas customs, Simeon's Christmas was a day of salvation. Simeon did not fear dying because he knew that he would depart in peace by the gospel of peace and would go to the Lord of peace. Have you had a good Christmas? Have you again welcomed Christ into your heart? Jesus is born to live in you and fulfill your days and your years and your entire lifetime. Yet perhaps, like Simeon and Anna, you have also waited for years to see Christ, to be freed from some need, some regret, some fear, some addiction, some challenge. Perhaps, like Simeon and Anna, you have spent long moments in prayer, waiting upon God. Perhaps you have lived in a dark place, hoping to see the light of hope and God's peace. The day of Christmas is that moment when the light of Christ that enlivens all people comes to you unexpectedly, perhaps without the carols, without the presents, without the food, yet he comes in the fullness of time, just in time, into your heart with a grace that goes beyond any carol or presents, fulfilling you with his peace. Take hold of that peace and that grace, those moments that you know you shall be released into God's peace and salvation that is promised to you and to all people. And yet we may not always hear God sending the Spirit of God's Son into our hearts. You know, the noise of the world, the distractions of life, the worries of work and family can make it difficult to notice the breath of God's Spirit breathing upon us. We may be disheartened by a world that never seems to be able to live and let live. We may be angry with God, lamenting the scale of human suffering that comes relentlessly to us over the television, across our computers and our devices. Yet the noise, disheartenment, worry, and anger does not mean that God is not present in this world or present in your life. There are moments when, like Simeon and Anna, suddenly we see and touch the fulfillment of time, knowing that Christ dwells in us, when we know he lives in me. The miracle of Christmas is Christ dwelling in you and through you in this world. This is the meaning of Christmas, when Jesus shares your lifetime so that you might share him in this world with those in need, those who are homeless, those who are hurting, those who stand on the outside, those who are invisible in this world, those whom we look through as if they were invisible. Christ fills you so that you might serve them. quieting the noise of the world, healing the anger and lifting the disheartened begins here in your heart, so that your days, years, and lifetime might become the fulfillment of time, who is Jesus Christ. Have you had a good Christmas? With the Spirit of Christ in your heart, Christmas Day will be with you a lifetime. Make good your day of Christmas, that Christ be born in you, and he who died for you will live with you all the year and all your lives. A blessed New Year and Christmas to you all. Together, let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us be together in prayer. With hope and expectation of Christ's coming, we offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all who await God's day of restoration. God of possibility, Mary responded with faith and hope in your promise. In our divided world, send your unifying spirit into our hearts, that the church may work as children and heirs of your peace and promise for all people through the light and love of Jesus, the Messiah. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of creation, guide and empower all who lead in government, industry, and academics to create policy and engage in research that will slow and repair the abuse of our earthly home so that generations around the world may, as children and heirs of your creation, enjoy the abundant environment that you continue to sustain. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of peace,
Look favorably on all your children and cause warfare to cease across this world. Lead nations and leaders, international agencies and organizations to work for peace and the cessation of war in every place in the world. Inspire all public figures to bind up wounds and heal the traumas of war. May they work to feed the hungry, care for refugees, and welcome the stranger. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of healing, grant healing and peace to the sick and the dying, and strengthen all caregivers, medical staff, and first responders who care for so many each day. We ask that you bless and keep our loved ones in your tender care. Jay, David, Virginia, Joseph, Robert, Rachel, Danielle, Carl, David, Van, Oakley, Arlene, Sergey, Bill, Jimmy, Roxy, Shirley, Ingrid, Martha, Tina, Ben, Louisa, Mindy, Danny, Sarah, Marilyn, Eileen, Jim, Christopher, Pat and Gary, Tanner, Michael, Ken, and Jean. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of eternity, in the fullness of time you sent your Son that we might receive adoption as your children. We thank you for your manifold blessings this past year and ask you to strengthen our work as a congregation as we seek to care for your many children in this world. Merciful God, receive our prayer. God of grace, we bless you for all your servants in every generation who lived according to your promise. Strengthen us by their example, and may we also see the coming of your Son in the new heaven and the new earth. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Draw near to us, O God, and receive our prayers for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Let us share Christ's peace with one another. Let us pray. God of abundance, receive and bless these gifts we have offered. Join our hearts with the song of the angels and gather us at your table of celebration. Strengthen us to share with all the world the abundance of your grace upon grace, poured out in Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding the God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. In which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all of them to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Glory to God in the highest. Come to the table of peace. The body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. God, our Redeemer, you have fed us at this table with gifts of grace, truth, and life. As you have gathered us in joy, send us forth as messengers of your peace. Make us shine with the good news of your glory, born to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God bless you and keep you. Jesus grant you grace and truth, and the Spirit send peace upon your hearts now and forever. Amen. Christ the Savior is born. Go in peace. Proclaim the good news. Thanks be to God.
Please join us for worship at 8:30 or 10:30 a.m. on Sundays with inspiring music and talented musicians as we gather around God's Word and celebrate the sacraments together. We are a congregation that helps children, youth, and families grow together in Christ. With events for children and youth, a confirmation program, educational activities, mission trips and retreats to camps like Lutheridge that help young people and families grow in faith and service to others. St. Mark's is a place for families and people of all generations to grow together in Christ. St. Mark's is a church with a servant's heart. Each Thursday, St. Mark's Soup Kitchen feeds our neighbors. We also partner with local schools and nonprofit organizations. We participate in Cairo's prison ministry weekends, sending cookies as a sign of our love. We follow Jesus in mission, offering food, shelter, and hope to those in need. And we are blessed by local artists, musicians, and ecumenical relationships. There's a place for you at St. Mark's. Please join us for worship and stay with us to serve Jesus Christ by helping others discover God's amazing grace. For more information about worship and service,